Hey, welcome back to the workshop. You know the action never stops. We finish one kit, we start gluing another one together. This is the 40 Ford Sedan Gasser by AMT in 1/25th scale. It doesn't say it right on the box, but it's actually a 3-in-1. You have to read it out. Stock, street rod, or drag fastback. It's got 6 tires, option to make it bone stock 40 or 39 sedan, or a street rod or a hopped up gasser. Let's take a look inside the box. It is part of the original art series, so they will give you this really nice print in the box to take a look at, save, stick to the refrigerator, and drive the wife nuts. You've got the option of the stock V8. I'm going to be doing this one as a stock 40 sedan or the worked over Oldsmobile 394. Make sure you decide what you want to build before you get going. You'll see that things are divided between drag, stock, custom. They spell everything out in the manual. Really nice for you, and that's why I wanted to show it to you. Now let's take a look at some of the major parts in the kit so you know what you're going to get with this re-release. We've got red glass with red lights, red side lights, and clear. Of course, I'll be using the clear. We've got our interior bucket body. It is a two-piece body that must be painted and then assembled later, because the way this assembles is you've got your interior bucket. You'll have to have your body all painted. Then you'll have to have your interior done and slide that inside. Then that will go over the top there and be glued in place. All right, that's how that's going to go together. So you can either attempt to mask this off when you get the interior done, glue it inside, mask off all your glass, and then paint it. Or you can do it in two parts. I'm going to attempt to do it in two parts so you can see how that goes right there. The frame is a simple one-piece job. You can see the stock exhaust is included in there. You can either paint that black and hide it if you do the dragster, or you can take your Dremel tool and dig that all out if you so choose. 39 and 40 parts are included. You got the 39 hood there. You got the 40 hood there. We've got the steelies. We've got a stock axle on the front end, which is what I'll be using. Or on the chrome tree over here, let's take a look. We've got the dropped front axle. We got the stock bumpers, we got the 39 grill, we've got the 40 grill, we've got an extra set of wheels right there for the dragster. There's our drop front axle, or we got the nice wheel trims, we got the optional Nerf bars, the chrome gas tanks, tachometers, gauges, all that stuff available for the option parts, or you can do it bone stock. One of the nicest parts of the kit, of course, is always the tires with AMT. You're going to get 4 stock Firestone skinnies with just a little bit of white letter printing on them, or go completely black wall, beautiful tread on there, or you got 2 nice Goodyear blue streaks, beautiful drag tires. They're going to look magnificent. You can do the black walls if you wish, but they always look so nice in there. And before we take off from this part, we've got the great set of decals that come with it. These are if you're going to do it any sort of a dragster or custom machine, you'll be all set. So, I'm going to go degrease the parts, and I'm going to start assembling, and we'll be back for the sub-assembly show-off. The kit goes together super smooth, all right? This is a whopping 90 minutes into assembly, and we've already test-fitted things. We got stuff going together. There's no problems at all. You're going to be left with a lot of cool parts when you assemble it, no matter which version you choose. Now, I'm going the stock version. You can see how nice it's sitting together. We got the engine in, we got the body on, we got the interior, just to make sure that it all fits before we pull it apart. I dulled the chrome down with my flat coat as usual, and I'll bring up the chrome luster on those just by wiping it off as I need to. We got the 40 hood, which once it's all aligned properly will fit right in there. That goes on well. On my model, I did remove the hinges from the hood. All right, because I don't need them. I don't pose it open. I either pose it on or off completely. We got the dash and the steering wheel on one tree that we'll need to paint. Those will be painted body color. We've got the wheels assembled. Those went together without any problems whatsoever. We're going to be using those with the trim rings. The wheels as well will be painted the same body color. And then the trim ring and the hubcaps will hide most of it. We got the front seat together. That's just your basic double bucket seat there. What else? We got the 39 hood left over. We've got the trailer hitch left over. On this tree, we've got roll cage. All right. We've got the closed off grill. We've got some inner wheel rings that aren't used on this one. We've got the hood scoop left over. For some reason, there's an extra running board in there. That's a cool part. You could have that, throw that in a parts truck or something like that. So you got a bunch of cool plastic left over when you're done assembling. Now, I also threw together the Oldsmobile motor because it just goes together so nice, and it comes with that nice engine stand in the kit. Now, of course, it'll sit flat if you don't have the headers on, but I probably want to use this kit, this motor, in something else, so I put it all together, put it on the engine stand. We won't be painting that, but we'll be setting that aside. Now, the body will just come right off the fenders. The interior is pushed inside, and that'll come out because we've got to paint that. Fits nice and tight in there, but pops out easily. Then the fenders come off the chassis. And on the fenders, what I assembled was I put that 40 grill in it, because I know that's what I'm going with, so I wanted to get a chance to paint that body color. You can see the flathead mounted up to the radiator. That all mounts in beautifully with the suspension. No issues whatsoever. Fits in tight, and all you got to do is just lean the radiator a little bit forward to get the hoses to release, and I'll be able to pull that out before I paint this. So we're going to head over to the paint booth. What I'm going to do is this is going to get painted black. The engine's going to be primed black and then painted a dark green. The interior, I'm going to go with a nice tan. I found a fully restored car online on Hemmings that I really liked. So I'm going to do a tan interior with a red dash and a lighter tan floor. I think it's going to look great. The body and the fenders are going to get primered gray, then painted a Ford maroon, as close as I can get to it. I'm going to be using a gloss colonial red, that darker maroon red, with the gray on there. It'll darken itself up a little bit. We're going to get some paint on stuff. I'm going to start washing the grills while I'm waiting for primer and paint to dry in between coats. We'll be back for an update when we get some color on stuff, let you guys see how it looks. I've got a bunch of parts out of paint, and they're looking good. Let's get this stuff out of the way. Look at that luscious red on that body. All right, that's two coats of Rust-Oleum, and she just, look at that shine. Watch that go back and forth. Woo! She's got some gloss to her. So that looks real nice. It's a little bit lighter red than I wanted, but so what? That dark red is going to look real, real nice on this stocker, okay? So you can see that there. We're just going to let that sit aside for a few more hours and dry up. It's already been drying for about a day. We've got the interior painted, the tan. Now the seats will be done a little darker. The interior will be left lighter. The door panels will be left lighter. We'll be able to get that all together and then shove that inside. We're going to future floor polish the seat so they look more of a vinyl-ish. We've got the wheels painted the same body color. They look great. Most of that's going to be covered by the trim ring and the hubcap. You're just going to see a little bit of red on there with those nice firestones. We've got the steering wheel. We've got the dash painted in the factory color. Now I have to go in and hand paint the details on the dashboard so that we just mainly have just the main dash in the red. We've got the flathead primered in black. That's going to be then painted the Ford dark green. Details picked out, and we'll be all done with that. That'll be ready to go. And we're done with the chassis. We've got that all painted black. All I have to do is pick out that exhaust and do a little bit of silver pen. What you do with the pencil on the silver pencil, for those that have questioned it in the past, we can do it right now. You just take it and you draw it sideways. And what that does is, as you go and as you work it and as you go down your raised areas, okay, now you've got all these small raised areas in there too to touch, but you can see it starts to bring out a little more detail, and it looks a little road dusty, a little used, a little scratched. Not a lot. Used but not used up, not all beat up, but a well taken care of car that does get driven to work every single day and driven around on the weekends when you want to cruise. That's just the silver paint pencil technique. So, what do I have to do? Main thing is working on the interior, get that dashboard in there, get the engine painted, and then we can get the glass and the... We can get the glass and the interior inside that beautiful body. We'll get the two body halves glued together. Put them right down together like so. We'll get those glued together. We'll get the hood on. We'll get it all sized up. Then we'll be able to do the black trim on the running boards and go from there. So what I'll do is, when I'm done with the interior and I'm about ready to stick it inside, we'll stop and take a look, see where we are, see how things look, see if we can get the metal axles in here, get some wheels and tires all put together so you can take a glance, and then we'll just keep moving forward. So I'll see you in a little bit. More and more color goes on everything, and it starts to look even better. You can see the interior's all done, and I did dirty it up a little bit inside. It's a tan-on-tan interior with a red dash, red steering wheel, white surround. I actually pulled up a picture of one that I liked restored that had a darker body color, but it had the same body color dash with the tan interior, and that's what I wanted to replicate. So that's ready to go. On the body, I still have to attach the teeny little vent windows and paint their very far edges silver. The body itself is just about ready to go. We'll get that interior out of the way. We got the running boards done. We got the headlights on. We've got the taillights on the back. And I've got the gas cap on. The taillights have to be painted with some clear red paint to bring those out for those chevron taillights. The body, of course, is still not joined because I have to put the interior in it and then slide it down. But that's looking real good. That is that tester's, or that Rust-Oleum red that I showed you earlier. Nice and glossy. The chassis is all done. The wheels are on. I went with the hubcaps, but not the trim rings. I'm doing a car that's maybe 4 to 5 years old that's been used every day. The trim rings are gone, but the hubcaps are still there. They threw them out. So I weathered the red wheels just a little bit with some black wash. Did the engine up in the Ford green with some black wash in there and some oil stains. Underneath, I did a very mild dirt slash scuffy rust look. Very, very mild, but just subtle enough that it'll stand out as a used car, not a brand new one. We've got the dash, or we got the grill painted in there. You can see it right in the center. All we have to do then is put the glass in, put the windshield pillar in, do some minor details, do the trim on the car with the silver door handles, put the rear door, the trunk latch, the handle on, glue that on, attach the bumpers and do the final assembly. So when I come back, take another look at that engine for you up closer. When I come back, we'll have this beautiful car all assembled. We'll be taking a look, see what we think about it. Before I take off, I'll give you another look at that interior. A little closer up, you can see the dirtying up of the seats is just done with tile grout and a brown wash. And the dashboard is done in that body color and the paint scheme that I looked up online. So I like that they had that kind of a Bakelite with a little clock on the side. I thought that was kind of neat. So I'm going to just keep working. I've got about another hour's worth of work to do here, and we'll have a final. We'll see you soon. The beautiful 1940 Ford sedan is done from AMT in 1/25th scale. Look how nice that comes out as a bone stock plain Jane automobile. I love doing them like this. That's why I do a lot of them like that. One of these days, I'll actually build one as a gasser or a dragster. But the kit goes together quite well. You're gonna, because it's an older kit, you're going to end up with a little bit of a gap around the hood and a little bit of a gap around the rear fender. Okay. Now, you could spend a lot of time trying to fill that in and deal with it. But when you look at it from right there, it's nothing worth writing home about. It fits just fine. It looks great. It's not a huge deal. You can see it around the corner there. It looks nice. I love that Rust-Oleum Colonial Red on there, that gloss. She just shines as you go by. The front end goes together nicely. I love that 40 grill. Make sure that on the three bars here, you do put some chrome on there after you do your black wash. They are chromed out. I use a Molotow pen. The headlights fit right. I love those steelies with the base hubcaps. I got rid of the trim rings. I prefer it as if they just threw those out and left it with the hubs and the regular steel wheel. Got our chrome trim on. Got our black running boards. Got our glass in. You saw the interior before it was popped inside. And then over the glass, what I did after I installed it was just rub it with a Q-tip covered in Future so it brings out a little gloss. I like being able to position the side lights open a little bit, give it a little bit of character, give it a little bit of style. You can see the dashboard, the interior, the windshield rib, the antenna are all included. Looks great. And of course, before we finish up, we'll pop that off to show off that nice flathead in there. That is a nice looking engine. No problems with that at all. And as we went before, underneath, we did that nice rust detail and accentuation. So even as a stock car without being a gasser or a drag model, you can build a very nice model out of the AMT 1940 Ford sedan. We'll see you at the next review. Link in the description to how you can get your copy of this kit and build your own gasser, street custom, or dad's brand new ride to go to work in every single day like I did. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see you at the next review.